Earlier in the show, Jason made a sticky toffee pudding. Now he's back with the granddaddy of all December delectables, Christmas pudding. Okay, you're rubbing your hands together, and so are we. Tell us what the Christmas pudding is, and then you can jump right into the recipe.
Well, you know, Christmas pudding, you said it, it's the granddaddy. It's the one that, like, I think you either love this recipe or you really hate this recipe because it's big, bold flavors. And I was just thinking, like, we used to make this recipe 12 months in advance and let it sit, because the longer it sits, the stronger, the bolder the flavors get. It's just awesome. So first you gotta make your base, though. And what I've got is I've got my butter and my brown sugar in here. I would normally add the suet as well, but I wanted to hold it back to show you, because I said suet. Suet is beef fat. Now, if you don't want to, you can take the suet out and put double butter in here, but I've got the suet beef fat in there and the butter. And that really does kind of give you a more of that kind of stick to the ribs, kind of make it really kind of stodgy, you know, Christmas pudding, right? But you bring that all together. If you've done that, though, you would simply just add in your eggs and let it come together. Now, while that's coming together, I need to talk to you probably about the most important part, and that is the fruit. This is raisins, it's got currants, it's got sultanas, it's got candied orange peel, candied lemon peel in here. Some people would even go with that, you know, the Christmas, like the red and the green fruit. I couldn't go that far, but and what you do is you put, it's a little scary, right? But whiskey in here, you got beer, I got a Guinness in this thing, right? And what we do is you actually pour your booze on it and let it, I want to say marinate. Mm-hmm. Isn't that what we do when we drink too much? We marinate. But marinate for at least 2 days. Let that flavor build, okay? And I mean, I wish you could smell that. It's insane. While that's done, then we're going to add in our flour to our mixture. And we're just kind of bringing it all together. And this is our base. Once you've got your base, just take this. And I've gone old school here. I've even got my classic British bowl, which I love this thing for baking. So, and you're just gonna take this base right there. And the thing with this is now, once you've got it, it's all about bringing it together, making sure that you've got the texture. So we're gonna add breadcrumbs to this. We're gonna add obviously a little bit more, you know, the orange peel and things like that, but also the spices. This is where the Christmas spice comes through. So you've got allspice in here. You've got some nutmeg, ground cinnamon, all those things you think about when you think about Christmas, or at least I do. And it's crazy how once this starts cooking in the house, it's just Christmas, right? So that, all that fruit with the booze goes in. Filling, lots of filling, right? You can get drunk making this thing. And then you just start folding that all together. And then, you know, now it's a little bit too wet, it's a little sloppy, that's where the breadcrumbs come. You start adding your breadcrumbs in there, just bringing it together, and it really does get kind of quite doughy. So, you know, I'm not going to do it today, but I did put in the recipe. The best thing to do is just put some gloves on and just get in there with your hands and mix it all together. But I got some grated apple, you know, I skinned it, peeled it, just grated it down. Some almonds, throw that in there. Look at this, it's just awesome. Oh, I feel like I'm back in my childhood. But you would mix all this together, and like I said, really, really mix it well. And that is the base to it right there, but it's also how do you cook this thing. We're not going to bake this. We need it to be very moist and, you know, and keep that juiciness in there. Uh-huh. So we're going to steam it.
Oh.
First thing, your traditional Christmas pudding bowls. You can find these in the stores. They're great. You butter the inside, and then what I do is, to make it easy to get out, just take a piece of parchment and put that right in the bottom like that. And then I'll actually, when my butter's not frozen, butter that again so that it really helps it to come out a little bit easier. And then once this would be mixed a little bit better, but we can just go for the TV, you would just pile it in. You gotta pack it right in. You know, we're not talking about cake and keeping it light and fluffy. We're talking about dense, rich flavor. So pack it right in there. Oh, I wish you could smell this. It's just that orange peels coming through, and definitely all that whiskey. Okay. And traditionally, Christmas pudding's like with brandy and rum, but we went with the whiskey just because I feel like it's a very nice Canadian touch. And there we go. Pack that in. But you'd fill it right to the top, maybe a little bit more, and then you would actually put another piece of parchment paper on top and then wrap it with foil and tie the string around the outside. The string is important because when this cooks, it's going to balloon up. You don't want the top to pop off. And then it's like, well, how are you going to steam this at home? Not everybody has steamers, right? So what I did is I just took a little container like this and put a little mesh screen in the bottom, put water in there, and I put that on my stove, put a little lid on top, and once I get steam, I just simply put this in here, put that back, and here's the crazy thing. 8 hours. Eight hours of slowly steaming, building that flavor. And if you want, take it off, do it another 8 hours tomorrow. The longer you cook this, the better it gets, right?
Wow.
But what you end up with, I know, it's just tradition. It's just got that flavor. But you end up with something that is, you know, it's very, very rich, very, very dense. And like I said, people love it or they hate it. Some people will actually pour more brandy over this and flame it. I like to just serve it with some nice icing sugar over top, you know, like that. But the great thing, again, is when you're ready to serve this one, you can just put it back in the steamer for another couple of hours to warm it up, pop it out, put it in the middle of the table, and it's ready to go.
That is fantastic.
Is the best Christmas pudding.
Jason, that is so cool. Like, it's nice to see the tradition. I've actually never seen that done. I don't think we've ever done that on City Line, and I did not know the process of creating all of that. Well done.
It's fun and it's easy and it's a little bit of British tradition.
It's certainly